You're watching Minity Maths. This video will give you an introduction to quadratic equations, and how to rearrange them into their standard form. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. So, what is a quadratic equation? A quadratic equation includes a term raised to the power of 2. In other words, a term that has been squared. Another phrase you may hear to refer to a quadratic equation is an equation of degree 2. Because of the squared term, we can't always solve quadratic equations the same way as we would solve linear equations. There are usually two solutions to a quadratic equation. These can include either real or imaginary numbers. If we plot a quadratic equation on a graph, it may look something like this. Can you see there are two points where the line crosses the x-axis? These are the two solutions. There are four methods we can use to solve a quadratic equation. Factorization, completing the square, using the quadratic formula, or using quadratic graphs. The best method to use depends on the equation and the question you are being asked. For example, some exam questions may ask you to use a specific method. To use any of these methods, it is always best to rearrange it into the standard form of a quadratic equation. This makes it much easier to identify the specific terms. Here is the quadratic equation in its standard form. And here are some examples of quadratic equations. Notice that some of them aren't in the standard form shown in the middle here, we need to rearrange them. But first let's have a closer look at the standard form for a quadratic equation. X is the variable, the value we don't know and want to find out. A is the coefficient of the squared term, this number can never equal zero. B is the coefficient of the term that hasn't been squared. And C is the constant, i.e. the number with no variable. The expression on the left-hand side of the equation will be equal to zero. Now let's look at rearranging some quadratic equations into its standard form. For a refresher on rearranging equations, see our video linked above, and in the description, below. As a reference, here is the quadratic equation in standard form. Have a look at this quadratic equation. We need to move all the terms to the left-hand side, meaning it will be equal to zero. Remember, when moving the terms across the equals sign, we change the sign. So 2x becomes minus 2x, and minus 5 becomes a positive 5. Now that the quadratic equation is in its standard form, we can identify each of the terms. A is the coefficient of the squared term, however, there is no number here, meaning the coefficient is simply 1. B is the coefficient of the term that has not been squared. In this case, B is minus 2. Finally, C is the constant term, with no variable, 5. This equation may not look like a quadratic at first glance, but let's multiply out the brackets. We end up with a squared y, as well as another y variable. Now we want all the terms on the left side, so we can take 7 away from both sides of the equation, leaving us with a minus 7 on the left side. We can now identify each of the terms corresponding to the quadratic standard form. This last example doesn't need any rearranging, however, you may notice there is no constant term. That is because the constant term in this equation is equal to zero, so it isn't shown. This equation is already in the standard form for quadratic equations. Let's identify the terms. Have a go at these practice questions and pause the video while you work them out. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more maths videos.